Daphne, can I ask you first of all to give us a response? What's your view on how charities have to interact to make their requests and how they do it now? How could they do it then?
I think you're probably needing a greater sense of sensitivity. Because if you ask someone what's wrong, obviously not interested or too busy or got something else on the line, leave it. Don't pressure that. And similarly, if it's on the telephone, if someone says, "No, I'm sorry, I'm far too busy at the moment," accept that. I think very often the fundraisers
sector. I believe passionately in what they do, but the stories of the Daily Mail really upset me, and I think that some things that charities do can actually undermine my lifelong belief that they are a good thing. So I'm a donor too, and I might just chip in to that effect. But let us move to our second question, which comes from...
And I think it was quite a shock to a number of people. But how will we get over it? I think it's just education. An endless stream of misery. Please help the flood victims, the drought victims. The tigers need saving, so do the hedgehogs. Baby elephants are orphaned, so are Haiti's children. What's in today's fine? Just five? Is this a record? Well, that can go straight in the bin. The mittens to Oxfam. I never respond to emotional blackmail. Leprosy mission? Send a cow? Mercy ships? Bible society? My favourite charities. I know they are well run. Earthquakes in Nepal? Hurricanes in Vanuatu? Another day? Another pile of suffering? Do I give to overworked donkeys in Spain, battered seal pups in Canada, or my beloved cats? Which appeals are genuine? How can I tell? By much of the world's standards, I am wealthy. I can afford something here, something there. But I cannot afford to spend my time, my days, coping with this endless stream of despair. Should we not be tackling the root causes? Man's inhumanity to man, cruelty to animals, the greed and corruption of governments. Inasmuch as you did it to one of the least of